Ireland was a very different place 40 years ago when women had to resign from their jobs if they wished to marry. And there's more to discover from Ireland in the 1960s.
The training of a nurse begins at the age of 18 when she enters the preliminary training school of a hospital. It will often be her first time away from home and the first major step in her life. Why does a young girl, freed from the discipline of school, decide to undergo at least another 3 or 4 years in a similar atmosphere and under an even tougher discipline?
Well, I always had a pressure of a nurse. I always more or less thought of her as a Florence Nightingale type of nurse. Hand in the feverish brow, etc. I like the glamour of the uniform, the glamour of doctors, the nurse going around carrying charts and helping patients. But there's an awful lot more attached to it than this.
Now we've seen that the thorax is bounded in front by the sternum and the costal cartilages, at the back by the vertebral column and the intervertebral discs.
The first 4 weeks of training are a period of acclimatization when the trainee gets her first taste of discipline and is introduced to the simple theory of nursing. Her initial enthusiasm and desire to learn will usually carry her through this transition stage. That is, allowing for the occasional daydream. But just at the moment, there's work to be done and things to learn. In 9 weeks, she has to be ready to don her uniform and enter a ward, at least looking like a real nurse.
The boys of the village learn boxing. They are taught by an ex-Irish guardsman, Mr. O'Connor, who has club nights twice a week. He has a well-fitted gymnasium in a hall in the village. Training is intensive and the standard high.
What blood vessel is it in French? The aorta. Yes, and if you cut this down, you'll see the...
In her first year, a nurse studies anatomy, physiology, hygiene, first aid, bacteriology, and practical nursing. Dissection plays an important part, and the local butcher can usually be depended on to provide the wherewithal for lectures.
In the old days, the rural handball alley was something of a men's club. It was here one came for chat about trade and the crops, or the chances of the Lilywhites and the All-Ireland. This alley is more elaborate than average, with gallery and artificial lighting. But though the game is still played with enthusiasm, you get the impression that there isn't quite the same zest as there was in the days when diversions were fewer.
Tara Keenan, you were born and bred here in Enniscorthy, and you're off to the United States today, I believe.
Yes, that's right.
Emigrating, in fact.
Yes.
Why are you going over?
Well, it's a great opportunity. I can get some training over there for whichever I'd like to come back maybe to Ireland with, which you can't get here.
In what line?
Advertising, preferably.
Did you consider working here rather than going away?
Well, I did, but you just can't. I mean, there's not that many openings for young girls now without any particular qualifications.
What age are you?
Just 19.
Have you worked here at all?
No.
What was Enniscorthy like as a town to grow up in? Did you enjoy yourself?
Well, from the point of view of people, I enjoyed myself and amusement, maybe not so much, there's not that much of it, but it's quite easy to make your own enjoyment around here.
Do you think you'd be homesick?
Oh, probably, most likely.
Well, the best of luck in America.
Thank you very much, John.
Sure. Huh? Good luck, Tara.
Thank you.
Thank you, nurse. I'm afraid, you know, the girl has been got, you know. There's not much we can do on it in that case.
Reporters may have to make as many as 40 calls to find and check a story which may only take a minute to read. Theirs is the glamorous but exacting side of the business. They can be sent to any part of Ireland or abroad to any country in the world. And once he or she leaves the office, a reporter never knows how long a story will take. The editor sits with his deputy and the sub-editors at the other end of the newsroom. Once a reporter has typed his story, copy it's called, it goes to the sub-editor's department. News may come by telephone, by word of mouth, or over the teleprinter machine.
Well, that's rather good for three, but still.
The news editor hears of a good story from a country correspondent and directs the switchboard operator to put the call through to a booth where a highly skilled typist takes the copy. Meanwhile, in the art department, photographs are checked and selected.
How many skins like this would be taken to would it take to make a full-length coat?
When we are talking about these top prices, that's for male skin. But you are not using male skin for long coats because the leather is heavier than female skin. So you prefer female skin for a long coat.
Would these female skins be cheaper?
Each of them, the skin itself, the one female skin is cheaper than a male skin, but that's because of its length.
Smaller?
Yeah, it's smaller.
It's very hard to run on the side of the road, very dirty these places. We'd have a good journey to go for water betimes. And even the fastest soap now is there betimes, using the kids who often fall in the water and fall in the dirt in places we are on the side of the road. And then we have no bathroom or anything for to wash them out or look after them, but we do our best for them. We'd often have to go a long journey for water, maybe.
Thank you.
It's very hard to look after kids on the side of the road. We'd be better off if we had a place for them, you know, to have a place with you off of the road and we'll take care of them better than what we are. We'd probably give them education or something like this, you know, we're left in place long enough. But we'd be shifted along, you know, from place to place. It's very hard on the kids.
In the main waiting room that once sheltered passengers to Galway and Westport, 20 or so girls from the village sit stitching the briefest of bathing costumes for other girls to wear on the beaches at Clacton, the Costa Brava and Dinar. Mr. Stewart, how long have you managed the bikini factory here in Uchtarad?
Oh, for about 6 years.
When did the factory start?
1958.
Do you sell most of the bathing costumes here in Ireland?
No, most are for export, but we do have quite a market in Ireland.
Is there a good sale for bikinis in Ireland?
This has been improving over the last sort of 5 years, and we're selling more bikinis now than we ever have done.
How many do you employ in the factory?
At the moment we have 21, but we have a capacity for about 50, though we have had some difficulty getting stuff in the past couple of years, but I think we'll overcome this.
There are more girls leaving the convent here in Crossmolina and looking for jobs. Are there any jobs for them in Crossmolina?
No, I'm afraid not. They have to go.
Has Crossmolina changed very much since you got married, say?
Yes, it has.
Has it made any difference to one of the jobs I'm sure you have, and that is shopping?
Well, I find that quite good. Even though we have the supermarkets in Ballina, still I prefer to shop in Crossmolina, support the hometown.
Now, Miss Carroll, you've been here quite a while in Dunmore East.
Yes, I'm here since 19 years last November.
And your husband is the harbour master
here? He's the harbour master here, yes.
Well, there have been many changes in the 19 years.
Oh, yes. The first year we came here, it was considered a very big fishing, and they'd catch now in a day, I'd say, practically what they caught that year. And that
but
was,
that's a funny thing. The herrings come and go, do they?
They come and go. That year was very good, and then there were several years were quite slack, and then it took up again.
A thing I noticed when I was in your house yesterday, an awful lot of letters lying around.
Yes, well, you see, the postman can't possibly get down to all the boats. There'll be 30 or 40 boats. So they send our mail care of the harbour master, and it's left with us, and then we distribute it to the men.
How much mail?
Well, I suppose there's 40 or 50 letters every day.
And they drop in at all hours of the day, do they?
Yes, all times.
This must be a great nuisance.
Oh, well, it's, you know, I mean, you'd hate to think of them without the mail. After all, I'm a sailor's wife, and I know what a letter means.
Operating theatre, a place we all think of with fear and trepidation.
I was very nervous. All the sterile tables, you're afraid you're going to knock something over. You're afraid you're going to touch something and sterilise it. Although I'd seen lots of blood and wounds, I was just a little nervous that perhaps I might feel a bit faint when I saw the actual incision. But I didn't feel faint, and there was nothing to be afraid of from there on. Dinner hour is a marvellous time for chatting. In the morning you're not really informed for chatting, but at dinner time you have a full three quarters of an hour and you've plenty to chat about and talk about what has happened during the day. And when we're on duty we don't have time for chat. It's all strictly business. So when you do have an opportunity to talk to your friends, you certainly talk.
What do you think, Harry? Will you give me an estimate?
Well, I think we'll be able to make a little look like a lot. 10-15 years ago, shaving was all the rage. Hair cutting was the sideline. Well, now, shaving is extinct, actually, and styling is taking over from hairdressing.
Styling? It's not the short back and sides anymore.
No, not the short back and sides anymore. The styling gives a greater variety of
But who gets it? Just the chaps who are the lady killers of the town?
No? Oh, no. No, in actual fact, the country lads, I'd say, are among the majority of our customers. They've got the money and they've got the time and they do knock around. And they are very hair conscious now.
Does this reflect a social change, would you say?
Oh, very much so, yes, because the difference between the town's lad and the country lad years ago was very, very marked insofar as the country lad was the backward one. Well, now with the advent of Machrana Ferrum and Machrana Thu and all these...
They're catching up.
They're passing us out in actual fact, yes. If the towns lads are not careful, the country boys will pass them out.
About romance, the love life?
Well, that is a problem. carry on, Olive.
Well, thanks for putting the onus on me, she is now. But, well, it's a case of, you know, they're here one night, they're gone tomorrow. But you can develop platonic friendships. Mm.
But you have a very high marriage rate among the hostesses there, haven't you? They've been marrying out of it.
What a year, and that's not too bad.
Yes. And not all millionaires either.
Yeah.
Well, what's Shannon like at night time, you know, for entertainment and so on?
Well, first of all, you've got the 24-hour service at the airport, which means you can always go out for supper for afterwards. Or if you're lucky enough and the banquet's over in time, you might get into some of the hotels before the half-11 licensing laws hit you. Or you have parties in the flats or...
Which is
houses.
Practically most of our social life because... Of course, we can't really start socialising until after.
Yes, you don't
o'clock.
Fit in with everyone else,
no.
So you have to make your own fun.
Exactly, so most of our entertainment is within our own circle of friends, if you like.
Anne, what do you do?
I work in one men's boot packing.
And you're engaged?
Yes.
Who to?
Packy McGee.
Is he from Glaslough?
No, he's from Armagh.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. I got information received this evening that potential customers would be in Wright's Bar in Glasgow, so I came along to advertise some of my products as I've recently become a commercial traveller. Housewives, do you want to keep the sheets on your bed sparkling clean and looking like new? You do! Well, lie on the floor.
Anne, you're the disc jockey in the discotheque.
Yes.
What do you think about dancing after midnight?
Thank you.
And what do you do?
Well, I'm a lecturer in Trinity, in Dublin.
What do you lecture in?
I lecture in English literature, Anglo-Irish speciality.
Thank you very much.
I stopped for a chat with Charles Daly's wife, Pauline, a Ballymore girl herself.
What about all these bits and pieces for your cake? Can you buy all these locally?
I do indeed, yes.
Is Ballymore a good shopping town?
It is quite good for in the grocery line, anyhow. There aren't many big drapery shops, of course, but you can get everything you want in the grocery line.
How many men do you employ here, Mr. Arnold?
Well, we have 18 at the moment. It varies in... it varies seasonally, yes. Somewhat, probably of 18 just now.
No, I ask because we've had conflicting reports about the state of employment in Enniscorthy. What would your views be?
Well, of course, you always have some unemployment, and you must have many that are not really suitable for the type of employment which is offered.
Well, what about this preponderance of women who are working?
Of course, you have the cases of men on the dole doing the shopping, minding the children while the women folk are at work.
It's very bad.
And I think this is a very bad thing, and psychologically and socially it is a bad thing.
Do you see this being perpetuated here?
Well, we're starting a new factory just now, and in the near future there's a new factory to start here to employ practically entirely women. And we need a factory to employ men, not women.